Welcome to Ladeus Gaming. I'm Dave the Head, and joining me today will be a very silent Grazoot. He is the Leafy Mustard, and he is going to be getting some money. He has skinks with lots and lots of agility. I don't think I like that. I have a little bit of cash, so I'm going to maybe buy something. I don't know. I have a bad... There's that passer. No. I have a bad feeling. I'm going to get beat up by those. Saurus, so... Let's just get an extra... The Blood Bowl Babes. And he's got 300k, so... Me personally, I would go with the Stabbing Skink or Sibley the Blocking Saurus. He went Halfling Master Chef. That's an interesting choice. That could very well screw with me. Depends on how well he rolls against my rerolls, because I don't have a lot of rerolls. So, I believe our game is the last game in Division 3 of the REL. I was out of town for a while, which meant no Blood Bowl, no computer, no internet. I know, I survived. It's amazing. So we'll yell at him when we get into the game, and I'll check the sounds because it may be loud, I don't know. I'm glad you guys have come back to join me. Hope you enjoy the game. If you got something to say, you want to throw some shade my way, always welcome the comments. I try to respond to everyone since my channel's quite small. The Fruity Kisses are doing a lot better. Right now I'm currently in third, but I haven't played this game. So if I win, I'll either be tied in second or will be second, and the other guy will be tied with in the third place. I know it's really weird, but... Alright, so he has chosen to kick. I'm going to check my sound levels real quick. I'll turn the FX up a little bit. Add a bit of music. I don't know what difference that'll make, but we'll see. The Halfling Chef has left me with at least two rerolls, and he's gained at least... You know, be honest with you, I don't know what he's gained. Saurus, he has the one with Block, and one with Mighty Blow. Sidestepping Skink. Agility out the Wazoo Skink. But he doesn't have any extra players. So... If I can hunt them Skink down with my Assassins, that might come in handy. Let's go ahead and remove some of my soft targets from the front. Thrower in the back here. Blitzer, blitzer. Blitzer. I don't need a kicker, so... Let's put... Lodge Blitzer over there. Mighty Blow Blitzer within. Fresh Blitzer over here. As much as I hate to do it, I'm going to put the agility guy up here. See if I can't use his agility to get the heck away from the Croxosaur. And we'll go with this setup. See if we can't get out there and cause some pain and destruction. Go ahead and cover the ball. I'm not worried about picking it up right now. I want to get into position to do some stuff. Going for it. So with that one. Go ahead and base a few of these Saurus. I know it's not always the best idea, but I'm gonna go with it. I thought about making the attack on that side, but I changed my mind. What I'm gonna do here is I have this mighty blow piling on fella. Let's see if I can use him to cause some trouble over here. Let's see if the Crush can live up to his name. No, he cannot. So in this case, we're going to bump. And haul ass. I think that guy's going to be our receiver if we live long enough. And there we go. 5 was not required, but it was enjoyed. If Zoot decides to say anything like normal, I will read it to you, as that the reading is kind of hard to do on the screen there at times. I guess maybe if you got a real big screen with a high definition, but I don't even know if I record that high definition or not. Probably not, knowing me. Hopefully I'm causing him lots of confusion, like, what the heck is this guy doing? I had hoped that the dodge there would be of help. It was not. That will burn a reroll. Worked out well. And Yellow Mustard is out of the game for the moment. He said he can't really type at the moment, and I'm telling him no worries. So it's just gonna be you and me, listener. So the first thing I'm gonna do is see if we can't bump this guy off and out of the way. We can, so we will. That up with. That looks like it. So. Our pickup went well. I believe Strong Arm's doing a thing, except I rolled a 2. One, I mean. So we'll re-roll that. Hope for the best. Nope, double ones. Nuffle has decided this game's gonna be Failatron 2000. Some successful smashing on his part. Man, double once. Get you every time. Definitely swarming the ball. Mm-hmm. Seems to be experiencing no problems with his dice. But such is Blood Bowl. So it's been over a week since I've played anything. Let's see if I can keep my salt levels down. Spend all this time now moving everybody back. Tackle zones are irrelevant against stunty players, so. There is that issue. Nothing cooking there, so that worked out in my favor. With his team swarmed up there, it's going to be very hard to get the ball out of there. And he may choose to just break for it. Especially if this Croxagore, whatever his name is. Croxagore. Especially if it continues working the way it has been. Stab against armor 9 is not going to be fun, but I will do it. See if we can survive the Mighty Blow guy. Stun. Could be worse. So I came back from my little vacation, and all of a sudden there were Nurgles everywhere. Okay, did re-roll that one. And it works out for him. Which is going to cause me to have a surf. Not sure what he's planning to do here. That's not good for anybody. I can't do it, so we'll just get forward a little bit. I accidentally go for it. Didn't punish me too bad. Let's go ahead and see if we can't get this guy out. At least it wasn't a one. Let's see if he decides to stall or go ahead and score while he can. Croxagore is succeeding in doing what it needs to be doing. Our armor seems to be holding up all right. Sorry about the dead quiet, I'm not sure what's going on. Okay, there he goes. So, failed pass really put me in a hole there, and here we are. And his Saurus is back. waiting to see how he sets up, if there's any difference this time. Doesn't look like there's going to be. So I'm just going to keep the positioning I have as well. Get one of my rerolls back. Just go ahead and steal this ball and get the hell out of Dodge and maybe get a score to tie this up with. Tying up some Saurus so that they can't just jump out and attack me. And over here, next to this blitz. Doesn't do a lot, but. I'll go ahead and re-roll it. I've got a 1-6. Can't beat it. Sometimes I think the game just wants to bleed you of re-rolls. If we can get this guy into scoring position, that'd be good, because Fig would level up, and then I'd have my assassins at level 2. Looking for a double for him to get multi-block. Of course, if not, and doesn't get anything special, then we're going to go with catch. Okay. So not willing to go down for the hit, just a push. Another push. And a follow-up. But double power over there leaves nothing to the imagination. There's another element of KO. That Croxagore is getting real good at going where he wants to go. Hopefully I'll have some boneheads in the next half. So how far? He can't get far enough to score. Gotta try to figure out what I want to do in this mess. Quickly getting outnumbered and out positioned. Just think about bringing the runner here, just passing back. But I'm also just thinking about dodging out and hope for the best. So that's worked out there. Did what I needed it to do. Throw some ill-advised blocks. Now I guess we're gonna eat that one. Don't think the dice are going to punish him in this half, so I'm going to just have to hope that they're done with me and I can just sneak away. I assume he's going to try to swarm me. So GFI will burn one reroll. Three skink blitz puts me right back into the Croxagore's paws. Guess I'm gonna have to do the one thing I don't really care to do, and that's just brawl. First of all, my team is going to be weaker than half of his, and outmaneuvered by the other half, so it's going to be very hard to get in what would be a favorable blitz or attack or anything. that worked out in my favor. Since that worked out in my favor, I don't have to use my blitz there, but I would like to use it here. Which means I've got to get you free. Worked out in my favor. Not quite what I needed, but I'll take it. And I will go for it. And it was successful. Oh, sneak that one in at the last minute. Story of my life in this league. One of my players is back. Value 7 people back a little bit. Put you there. Not sure how I want to set this up. And tells me no matter what I do, I'm gonna get beat up. Put the blodging guys on the line. That's not where I normally want them. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. He can get in and hit wherever he wants, but he'll only be able to do it with one. I do have kick, so that will help me, hopefully, put the ball somewhere annoying. Fine, how do you do? I suppose I need to watch out for the skinks that are going to move forward. They're going to be my biggest problem, so I'm probably going to go back here in the corner. Shame you can't re-roll a kickoff from time to time. He does get the free step forward, that's going to be annoying. I know where it kind of where he's committed to. So hopefully he'll get jammed up over here and won't be able to score this half again. All for the love of double ones. Maybe I get lucky and he'll roll some double ones. Blodge don't help against 3 dice. I did commit a lot of sorus to that. So far, I've been lucky on the armor roll. Bonehead finally decided to punish him. Well, not punish him, but do its work. Do its job. Do your job, Bonehead. Save me from your angry Croxazord. Croxazord. It's a Mighty Morphin Power Zord. That's a reroll to a push. I like that. So I'm not sure what he's doing with these other skinks, but he has committed a lot to here, being that the only ball carrier, but here we go. The backup ball carrier. And the backup to the backup ball carrier. No. Pickup goes without a hiccup. Put him there. In here. And that will allow for this very bad idea. See if this helps. It does. Our friend the kicker here won't be doing a lot, so let's go ahead and move him over, and just in case, let's give this a shot. And that's that, as far as I'm concerned. That should stop him from scoring. He just physically can't get through there. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Well, he can, but he has to do a lot of dodging, I think. Plus some handoffs and other troublesome activities. Well, that's going to be helpful. He may just decide now's the time to beat all elves. A fancy little push. This guy is in two tackle zones, so it's going to be very hard for him to get the hand off. Unless he bumps some people. Thank you. he's going to get the kickback. So, there is that. Waka waka doodah, yeah. I am going to move you. Yeah, I'm gonna leave that like that. Just in case I get some kind of a kickoff event. You know what? Let's actually change this. I don't have to be so conservative anymore. If he's going to score, I'd rather he score now and get it over with. Let's see how bad this burns me. It doesn't look like the Halfling Chef did all that much more. I have two rerolls again. He has four again. Hopefully, I can get a blitz, and that will make all the difference in the world. He got the high kick. So that should help him out pretty well. Especially with an agility 5 skink. He is down 1 skink for whatever help that gives me. Okay, didn't expect that. Guess he's going for like a long stall with just a mad rush at the end. Because he knows he can beat me on the fighting game, even with my skills. Blows giving me a fright. I'm not going to be able to get to that guy. So, what I need to do is try to watch these other skinks and see what kind of trouble I can cause them. But his reroll worked. Lovely. Okay. He chose not to follow, but to go there instead. Okay. First things first. And I got boxcars. Not bad. We'll go ahead and commit over here to do this. Yeah. gives me one die here, which I will take a one die. So there's that. Let's use my dirty player here. No, that's the kicker. Dirty player here. I can't get over there, so I'm not worried about that. Well, in that case, what I will do is not go for it. Don't want to go for it. But I will give this one a shot. Double ones is enough to tell me not to do that again. Hey! Around this pile of Saurus. See if we can't win the red die block war over here. Which we can. Go from there and see what he does. With four Saurus on their back and a stabbed Croxazor, I'm pretty happy with that outcome. He's got a few options here, I can see right off the bat. He may decide to just rush down the middle here by pushing this or hitting this guy out of the way, then blitzing that guy off. He can move up, hand off, and just come down the middle. I don't know how much cover he would have. But I would definitely give Stab a shot. I think this guy's going to get Leap. I'm gonna give that a shot, see how it works. It may be a while before you see that. Okay, we have movement from the Thesaurus. There is the push. There's the blitz. Okay, so he wanted more than a push and was willing to pay for it. Hopefully that will punish him when he tries to hand off and there's a failure. And now for the moment of truth. Is this going to happen the way I thought it is? And if so, will it work? Not happen the way I thought it was. So what I will do is go ahead and move him down here. Put a little bit of pressure on the guy. Let's see if this works out in my favor. it's a stun, and I'm all right with that. If I got this right, I should have... Yes, I stole his assist there, so I can do this. He's injured, so I don't have to pile on. Bonus. I'm going to commit one more dude to commit the kickoff this way. That's the dirty player. I could, but I'm not going to. Let's do this. Try this red dice. I'm gonna let it sit. I don't like it, but I'm gonna let it sit. It's probably gonna hurt me. I got away with it. So I've hopefully cut off some of his retreat. I like, not his quick retreat. I mean, he can still get out. There's nothing I can do. I can't box him in. He's got a movement of 8. He's got 5 agility. He ignores tackle zones. The only thing I can do is get into position to hit him later. And it's going to take a while. So right now, he is running a long stall game, it seems. Though the skink passing game is something I just thought about right now, so he can make a pass with that just as well as any elf can normally pass. That's a reroll to a push. So with that burn of a reroll, he probably won't make a pass. Depending on what he does next will dictate how kooky. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I can make that, and I will. I still will, unless he's doing a pass. He is. He is. Okay. I intercepted because elves. Six. Didn't need it, but I rolled it, and I'm glad for it. Quite surprised, to be honest with you. Alright, so that's that. I'm going to... over here. Make this stack. Didn't do, but it's alright. I'm doing okay right now. Let's see if this pass works. Just don't need any ones, kids. And against my better judgment. Oh, I really want to stall. But I hate it so much. I'm gonna stall a little bit. I really hate stalling. And Zoot, if you see this, know that this, you're dangerous to me. And that's the only reason why I'm doing this. Because it goes against my better judgment and everything I do. I mean, I can 30 player this up a little bit. 58. 72. I will give out a shot. Why not? I'm off the field, but so is he. Unless he apothecaries it. Oh, man. So I gotta say thank you to the REL, or I'm sorry, the Rebel administration for delaying the rollover. Due to the holidays, letting me get in this game. I was the last person in my league. I'm glad it lets me at least fight to keep my position. I know I won't go far down, even if I did get a loss due to concede, but I do appreciate having the chance to try to, you know, to try to beat the Zoot. Yes, I would give shadowing a shot, but it didn't do anything, so. I think I'm just going to try this blitz stab here, this stab here. May commit to a block over here, I'm not sure. But most likely I'm gonna score on my turn, because this is making me super nervous. My kicker doesn't really need a level up, but I need a touchdown. Getting to that point now where every movement feels like it could be a horrible mistake. So he's got Leaf Me Alone here in the midst of a movement. He can finish doing something with him. But that's realistically it. I'm not sure what he's doing, what the thought process is here. He's pretty much committed everybody else. He may decide to bring Leaf over here to help this one location, but I really doubt it. I had thought about grabbing Dates here and moving up next to this guy to steal his downtime, but it doesn't look like that's going to be a thing. I will, however, come on over here and stab me some skinks. The sidestep don't matter when you get stabbed. Did anything, so let's give this a shot. Go ahead and score, be done with this mess before I get in trouble. Second verse is same as the first, only this time he can't stall as much as he did the last time. And that skink stays out, so he's down to two skinks. All I gotta do is make sure that none of them pop back. Alright, my cheater elf is the one that got kicked down. cold mister and likes to kick them while they're down. And we'll try for the blitz again. Because who knows? Might get lucky. I'm going to kick over here this time around the Agility 5 Elf. See if I can't get under that ball if I do get the blitz. Well, I guess it depends on where he keeps his Saurus. I think if he had went with something else besides that Halfling Chef, I think he would have been a lot better served. An extra player would have helped him out big time. I don't know. I like star players. I know everybody else doesn't. But he could have got the Fireball, the Apothecary, and the Blood Bowl Girl. And the Blood Bowl Babe would have got Red Leaf there up. Okay, we are about to get jumped over here. Is not a protection against power. Boom. Cherry got crushed. He missed the dodge there. That was a hell of a misplay. Didn't re-roll it. Oh, give me a break. Alright. Salt level increasing here, kids. Go ahead and let that... Man. To not only misclick, but get the loner and a 6 dodge. I'm afraid that one really does piss me off. I have sympathy for the misclicks, but... Okay, let it go, Dave. Let it go. Woosah. Everything is awesome. Everything is great when you're part of a team. Okay. Didn't see that one coming, but I'll take it because stuff. Alright, let's put you here. Make sure you watch your tackle zones, Mr. Head. I want to do the same thing he did. Gotta get over there to put a tackle zone on that ball. And I made it. This one's just to put a tackle zone on this guy. You know what? I'm doing it. One, two, three, and I'm not re-rolling it. Okay. I guess if you're going to have a one, that's the one to have a one. Dodge did a thing. Luck I'm gonna have here is that he has no more rerolls. So that did what it needed to do. Freebie first. Didn't do it. I do not want to one die block that. Or one die block here. And be punished for it. Doubly so. Oh my gosh. Don't know what to do with this shit. Don't be salty. Don't be salty. Don't be salty. Alright, that's pushed into Croc-a-whatever. Didn't expect that. Well, if I'm gonna get fucked, I might as well get fucked attacking somebody. Well, folks, I don't know what to say to this. I hope you've enjoyed the game. I do think that a lot of it was well played. I do think those last two turns came down to a lot of BS dice rolls. Maybe I made a mistake by doing the one die block. I don't know. Try to level up one of these elves. Cherry here has the option to level up, but I'm going to try with a pineapple most likely. And make a pass with him and get his level. Yeah, the only option, I mean, the only hope I have here is if, realistically, if they give me an extra turn, a riot. So, he said, good game, well played. I thanked him and said to you too, then reminded him not to listen to this game because of my saltiness. Oh, it's my turn to set up. Sorry. Alright. It's my turn to set up. Let's move you back here. You there. He's a strange fellow, that's for sure. I am definitely gonna go for a free stab because F it, why not? And here we go. I blame the Kiwi kid for all my woes. Alright, first things first. Stab this guy. Second thing. Let's still go. Material. That's the first time I've ever seen that animation for Dark Elves. It's a little lackluster. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and try to get my vanity pass on. And it's a drop. Awesome. Thanks. Oh. Kiwi kid, let me down. Rolling all the ones. Metal, if you watch this, you may hate assassins. Mine's soon to be runners. I did make some cash, and Orange Crush got the MVP, so he did need that. That's pretty cool. His Mighty Blow guy got his MVP. 6, 7, 8, 13, 8, 12, 15, 18. So we will validate that mess. Wait for him to validate his mess. Alright, there we go. We'll go ahead and do our level ups. Roll them bones. A 6. So, as I said, we didn't get our doubles. We're going to go with catch. Though, probably dodge might have been a better idea. But screw it. We've made the commitment. And a 3. Alright. Strip ball is what I'm going with here. Yeah. He has blodge, so strip ball. And there we go. So I am now in third in our division. Because that gives me a tie instead of a win, so I'm 8-2-2. And we'll see you guys on the next one. Later.